Hello again, Duck on the Clock with more Super Mario Kollision by Henrique. Time for the second Star World level, Fort of Gravity. A tingle in anticipation. Let me guess, you need that for some reason or another. Oh, this is crazy. Okay, you don't even have to go on the platform. Fair enough. I know why it's even there if you don't have to go on it, but... Oh, jeez. And there's lava that makes absolutely no sense whatsoever. And a P-switch that just kind of appears. Whoa. That I probably need in some capacity. Or not? Maybe it's part of the secret exit. Oh, well, no getting through there without taking a hit, or, well, maybe if I slid properly. But first, I'm gonna go over here and see if there's anything. To reload, I have to reload, and that'll give me a power up back. Testing, testing. Whoa, okay. Why can't I see these guys? Well, it seems like one boss is here. It's beyond me how... Well, maybe you're supposed to use a bomb to break that. Ugh. Poorly designed level again. Although it feels like it was also... It feels like it might have been taken from somewhere, too. So, I don't know who I should blame for it. Let's see if we can find that secret exit before we have to resort to lunar magic. I see. Well, door entered. I don't even know where I am. Okay. Well, there's... At the very least, there's almost nothing that... this stage can do to me. Okay. Oh, that's not it? Well, at least a door spawned. Oh, and that's just a goal. It's the design decisions are very, very strange. As usual. Well, at least we've got our secret exit there. Don't have to worry about that anymore. At least things worked better than Color Palace. I'm gonna take the upper path first. Because the lower path leads to another star road, and I just don't not ready for another star road yet. Brikc Desert. Wait, what? Oh boy. Yeah, so, typical for a hacker of such ignominy, Henry Game made a level I couldn't actually beat. Because you die the moment you enter. So, what I did was, I added in a bunch of cement blocks all over the place so that I can actually survive. It was a very haphazard job, so don't expect any level design awards or anything, but... hey! I did what Henrique couldn't do and made the level actually completable. Oh boy, goodness gracious. This is a disaster of a game. Let's not beat around the bush here. Cold Lake. Wait a sec, that's... uh-huh. So, my guess is Henrique didn't actually change this one. Except to completely mess. Except that the graphics are completely and utterly messed up. Great. Okay, well, I know how to beat this one, so. I will speed through it. Oh, hey, there are some, Bowser statues, which are now Magic Koopa statues, that actually make things slightly, very slightly different. Boring, pointless stage! Again! Over and done with, though. Oh no! Apparently didn't change this one, either! Well... okay, time to go through it. Why am I being taken here? How badly broken is this place? There was a wall here. It's gone now. I wonder if this, the castle is even able to be beaten. Well, this level is, completely and fundamentally broken. It's, what doors work go to the Castle of Color, so I just, did a bypass. Can't say that I'm terribly disappointed in that. Anyway, I think I'm done with this. I'm not sure that these levels have are even changed. Well, I guess I'll, well, let's find out, at least. Butterbridge 1 appears to be Butterbridge 1. Butterbridge 1 is Butterbridge 1, and Butterbridge 2 is Butterbridge 2. I checked that out in Lunar Magic. I'll beat those and then move on to new-ish content next time. Anyway, that's all for me for now. Until then, this is Doc.